Welcome to a lesson on graphing a linear equation in slope-intercept form. The equation y equals mx plus b is called the slope-intercept form of a line. This equation represents a line where m is equal to the slope of the line and b is equal to the y-intercept of a line. Remember, we can define the slope as the ratio of the rise to run for a line, or more precisely, we can define this as the ratio of the change of y to the change of x. So if we can look at the equation in slope-intercept form and identify the y-intercept and the slope, this is enough information to graph the line. Before we take a look at our examples, let's look at an animation that shows how the values of b and m affect the line. Notice right now we have the equation y equals 1x plus negative 2. So we have a slope of positive 1 and a y-intercept of negative 2. Notice the line crosses the y-axis at negative 2. And then looking at these two points here, notice the ratio of the change of y to the change of x would simplify to 1. Now notice as we change the value of b, the slope doesn't change, but the y-intercept does. So the line is still slanted the same way, just the y-intercept is changing. So if we pick two points on the line, any two points actually, notice how the ratio of the change of y to change of x would still simplify to 1. Let's move the y-intercept to positive 3. And now we'll try changing the slope. But notice right now when the slope is positive 1, the line slants upward from left to right. And as m increases, notice how the line becomes steeper. And as the slope decreases and becomes negative, notice how the line slants downward from left to right. Now let's look at some examples. We first need to recognize that y equals negative 2/3 x plus 1 is in slope-intercept form. The slope is equal to negative 2/3, and the y-intercept is equal to positive 1. So m is equal to negative 2/3. I'm going to move the negative up into the numerator, so negative 2 over 3, which again is equal to the ratio of the change of y to the change of x. And then b is equal to positive 1, which means the y-intercept is the point 0, 1. So we'll start by plotting the y-intercept, which is positive 1. And then because the slope is negative 2/3, we'll go down 2 units and right 3 units. Again, we went down 2 units because the numerator was negative 2. We went right 3 units because the denominator is positive 3. And now our line is going to pass through these two points and would look something like this. So as you can see, if a line is in slope-intercept form, graphing the line is very straightforward. Let's take a look at another example. Here we have y equals 5x minus 2. So the slope is equal to 5, and the y-intercept is equal to negative 2. So if the slope is equal to 5, we want this to be in fraction form. So we're going to write 5 over 1. Again, we want this to be a ratio because it tells us the ratio of the change of y to the change of x. And then b is equal to negative 2, which means the y-intercept would be the point 0, negative 2. So now we'll plot the y-intercept, which is negative 2. And then from the y-intercept, we'll go up 5 units because the numerator is 5. And we'll go right 1 unit because the denominator is positive 1. So up 5, right 1, we would be here. And our line passes through these two points. Let's take a look at another example. Here we have y equals x. Remember, m is the coefficient of x, and b would be the constant. So if we want to, we can rewrite this as y equals 1x plus 0, which means the slope is equal to 1, but we do want this to be a fraction, so we'll write this as 1 over 1, which again is the ratio of the change of y to the change of x. And since b is equal to 0, the y-intercept would be the point 0, 0. So again, we'll plot the y-intercept, which is right here at the origin. And then because the slope is 1 over 1, we'll go up 1, right 1. And we can do this several times if we want. Up 1, right 1, up 1, right 1. Our line passes through these four points. And would look something like this. Now let's take a look at one more example. Here we're given the equation 3x minus 2y equals 8. This linear equation is not in slope-intercept form, so we'll solve this equation for y and put it in slope-intercept form to identify the slope and the y-intercept. So the first step here, we're going to subtract 3x on both sides. So this would be 0, so we'd have negative 2y equals, and now we'll put the x term first, so negative 3x plus 8. And now to solve this for y, we'll divide everything by negative 2. So we have y equals, this would be positive 3/2 x, since we have a negative divided by a negative. And then positive 8 divided by negative 2 is negative 4, so we'll have minus 4. So now we can identify the slope is equal to 3/2, and the y-intercept is equal to negative 4. So again, m is equal to 3/2, and b is equal to negative 4. So the y-intercept is the point 0, negative 4, which should be here on the y-axis. And then with a slope of 3/2, we'll go up 3 units and right 2 units. Up 3 units and right 2 units. And our line passes through these points. So of all the forms of a linear equation, the slope-intercept form is probably the most popular because it is the easiest to graph. I hope you found this helpful.